Where can I download Windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question I got, I've lost my Windows installation disk, but I possess the product key. What should I do if I want to reinstall Windows on my computer? Can I download Windows somewhere? Well, first, one of the things you can do, of course, is to take a full system image backup of your computer right now to use as a fallback. You can always restore that image instead of a reinstall, and you'll be back to where you were at the time you took the backup. You could also get in touch with the vendor who sold you the computer. They provided you with a copy once, perhaps they'll get you a replacement copy. You could buy a new copy of Windows. Most people aren't interested in doing that because they don't want to pay for something they feel they've already purchased. That's when most people resort to finding a place from which to download Windows. Depending on the version of Windows and where you find it, it might be legal, or it might not. It's been my understanding that for years, downloading a copy of Windows from just about anywhere was illegal. Even if you had a copy of a product key to activate it, simply downloading a copy of the software would, I guess, break copyright law. I believe that's still true for versions prior to Windows 8.1. I know of no legal places to download Windows XP, Vista, or 7, or actually now 8.1. Beginning with Windows 7, however, Microsoft did make full ISOs of the operating system available for download. You still need your product key. The product key cannot be downloaded for free. You'll need to have one that works, not all do, or purchase a new one. There are some exceptions around the Windows 10/11 upgrade path. Legal issues aside, I will say this. In my opinion, downloading Windows is ethical if and only if you have already purchased a valid product key or the machine you are installing on already has a digital license from a previous installation. So personally, I got to cover my assets and include this bottom line caveat. If you elect to get this download from anywhere other than Microsoft itself, you're assuming all risk and potential liability relating to its legality, not to mention its security. Okay, downloading Windows 11. Yep, I have a link. It'll be in the description, and more accurately, it will be in the companion article for this video at askleo.com/5052. You can download the US English version directly from Microsoft. My assumption is that while my link goes to the English version, if you are elsewhere, it will automatically redirect to the appropriate version for you. Even though Windows 11 may automatically download on some machines, downloading the ISO or running the installation assistant is often the fastest, most reliable way to perform an upgrade or a reinstall. You can download Windows 10 directly from Microsoft as well, at least for now. And again, that's a download of the US English version that I am assuming will automatically redirect as appropriate. Okay, what about 8.1, 8, 7, Vista, XP? These versions are no longer available for download from Microsoft. They've been unsupported for many, many years at this point. While there may be third-party download sites containing images for these operating systems, you have to be extremely careful, as those often include unwanted extras, like malware. A couple of things to know about your Windows download. For one thing, it's big, really big. You're looking at a download of several gigabytes for most Windows editions. Depending on your internet speed, that could be anywhere from a few minutes, a few hours, to several days worth of download. This is true whether you download an ISO file to be burned to a DVD or run the media creation tool, which should let you create bootable USB. Another interesting tweak is that it's not OEM. These downloads from Microsoft are the generic retail versions of Windows. If your machine came with a copy customized by your original equipment manufacturer, OEM, then those customizations will not be present, and your product key might not even work. Product key issues aside, this typically means that after installing this copy, you need to get any missing applications or drivers from the computer manufacturer directly. If your product key doesn't work, well, to begin with, make sure you download the edition of Windows for which your product key was originally issued. This means matching the Windows version, say 10 or 11, the edition, Home, Pro, something else, and possibly the quote-unquote bitness, as I like to put it, the 32 or 64-bit version. If your product key is an OEM product key, it may not work with the retail version download, even if everything else matches. There's no legal way around this that I'm aware of other than to return to your computer manufacturer and ask for a replacement Windows disk or to purchase a retail product key. You can, of course, download Windows without having a product key at all. Windows 10 and Windows 11 will run, but with an assortment of features disabled until you activate the product with a key. Now, of course, you can purchase Windows as a direct download from Microsoft, including a valid product key. But if all you're looking to do is reinstall a previously installed version of Windows or potentially take advantage of a free update, there's no need. Download the edition you want, type in your product key, perhaps, and you're on your way. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic, including the Windows 10 and Windows 11 official download links, visit askleo.com/5052. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.